It is April 1st today, a bit of a crazy day, and apparently as of today and only today, there is a new mutation mission available in StarCraft 2, and it's called Sudden But Inevitable. Amon's corruption is overtaking everything and everyone. Soon even your closest ally will betray you. It's clear no one can be trusted, there's only one option left. Destroy them before they destroy you. Now, I haven't played this myself just yet, but I'm gonna make the assumption that this is actually going to be sort of like a player versus player in the co-op mode with all of the different commanders available. Now, considering we're gonna be facing off against another player, I'm gonna make the assumption that pretty much everyone is just gonna rush and cheese as soon as they possibly can. And for that very reason, I think someone like Swann is just gonna be... I mean, maybe you can survive with all of the static defense early game, but someone like Swann is just gonna be a bit weaker, while his maxed out army is pretty much unstoppable. Getting to that point is gonna be very, very tricky. Now I come to think of it actually, maybe someone like Karax would be incredible because you get the Spear of Adun, and of course you can still cannon rush as well. You can just simply, you know, drop down a lot of the Spear of Adun energy right on top of your opponent's workers really early on into the game. You just need to get vision, and maybe someone like Alarak as well, who's got the default and overcharge, could be incredible. Actually, now I think about it a little bit more, it seems like every single commander in the game could potentially be useful here. Now, the map that we are playing on is the Steppes of Betrayal, and I don't really know what that is, but I'm gonna make the assumption here that it may very well be the Steppes of War. This used to be a letter map way back in the day, and it was absolutely tiny. You know what? It's been a little while, but let's go ahead and give Alarak a try here. As far as my mastery points go, I got the Alarak attack damage increase, which is just sort of going to be a given. We got the empower me duration as well, because basically all we're trying to do is get Alarak out, right? And once he's out, I think he's just going to be able to dominate the battlefield. But with that, we also got the structure overcharge shield and attack speed, which should allow me to, at the very least, survive the earlier stages of the game. At least I hope so. All right, game number one. I'm going up against a Nova here. I'm not entirely sure what I should go ahead and do. Look at this map. It is Steppes of War. I think I'm just going to go ahead and send out a probe really early on so I can potentially go for the structure overcharge right from the get-go here.
Main objective detected. Destroy at will.
All right. So that's going to be our main objective. We just need to simply destroy someone. Fair enough. Apparently, I've been recognized in the very first game. This is Steppes of War, by the way. Look at it. It's absolutely tiny. Anyway, I'm going to try and sneak out a worker here. How long does a pylon take to build? 25 seconds. Okay. Here we go. So here's my plan, okay? The best defense is the offense, right? I feel so gross already. Get out! Alright, next up, we'll go ahead and get ourselves a gateway here. And we can go ahead and just simply photon overcharge this right from the get-go, right? Because Nova is not going to be able to spawn for another little while. And we'll take a gas here as well, but I can go ahead and just simply overcharge this just like that. Oh my god, look at that! Can I target fire down his base? Is that a thing? Sadly, he's not quite going to be able to reach, but I think as soon as Alarak comes out, he's going to be extremely powerful. Now, Nova, of course, does have all kinds of aggression as well. Oh my god, we do so much damage with that. Look at that. That is ridiculous. Loco, you're disgusting. That was gross. Anyway, so I think we're just going to make Ascendants and Alarak units, okay? And with Alarak units, I mean, not the plural, because there's no such thing as several Alaraks. That would be a little bit overpowered. We'll go ahead and get ourselves the cybernetics core here as well. But as far as the early game goes, we've just completely massacred my opponent's base here already. I can go ahead and warp in some of the Ascendants here as well, or the Supplicants rather, not the Ascendants. Those are the High Templar. I wonder if I should go ahead and get some gas. I can always get some... I can always go ahead and get some more upgrades, I suppose. You know what? I'm just actually going to stop making probes right now. There we go. I am disgusting. All right. We'll go ahead and grab ourselves some... we'll go ahead and grab ourselves some more stuff. Alarak is going to be out here as well very shortly. And we're just going to move across the map. I think this is going to be a 1-0 for Loco. I think this is going to be a 1-0 for Loco, because while Nova will be out here in just a little bit, and I do have to be a little bit careful. I actually don't want to rush across the map, I suppose. I'm going to also be able to use this pylon here for... Oh my god, that's ridiculous. I can also go ahead and just simply use the pylon here for warp ins, right? Which should work out just fine. Yeah. Too long. Alright. Alarak is out. Alarak is out. Now, of course, I think that Nova will be out right around this time as well, so that is something to keep in mind here. So yeah, Nova is indeed trying to take that one out right now. I don't know how many gates I'm gonna be able to afford here. Regardless though, Nova is here now. Is Nova gonna be permanently cloaked? I don't even know how she works. We do have Empower Me ready to go though, so I think I just can simply massacre everything that's available. You know what? I can simply shoo her away just like that, right? Although she is currently trying to snipe me. Got her. Got her. And that should be the end of this already, right? Because we're just going to be able to massacre everything. I can warp in, I guess, at home here for just a little while as well. But that is going to be all she wrote here for game number one. Because we ended up obtaining the victory quite nicely. Now, maybe my opponent won't just leave early on. But I think, yeah, we will end up picking up the victory here quite easily. Alright, so game number one, I managed to get 195,000 XP there. Not bad, not bad at all. Now, I'm not done just yet. Next up is Zagara. And these right here are my mastery points. Alright, Zerklings and Banelings. Zerklings and Banelings is what it's gonna be all about. Now, we are going up against a Stukov here. I think that survival will be the most difficult part. I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, we'll try and not make anything here until I can get my spawning pool started. Of course, we do get three Zerklings here.
Located. We must destroy it.
Sure. Of course, right, I get two larva, or I get two drones rather per larva, and then three Zerklings per larva as well, which is stupidly powerful. It's just that surviving until that point is gonna be a little bit tricky. Actually, this is not all too bad. I'm trying to think here of what potentially my opponent could be doing here. Of course, he's gonna be playing rather aggressive himself as well. We'll get a couple of sets of drones out right now, just to increase my my mining for a little while. I'm also gonna try and get my metabolic boost here too. And maybe I should actually consider getting a queen now as well. Just because we're gonna use that for early game defense in case my opponent is trying to get tricky, or cheeky rather. Of course, he does have like the infest building and whatnot. Can you actually use that on my hatchery? Oh my god, that is a Psy Emitter. Yes, he's sending it straight across the map. I didn't actually consider that he could maybe just infest my building right from the get-go. You know what? We'll get a single queen here. Once Zagara is out, life is gonna be all fine and dandy. But before that point, this is gonna be a little bit difficult. So I'll go ahead and get myself an overlord here as well. I can actually see his Psy Emitter. We'll see exactly what's going on though here very shortly. Of course, I also want to make sure that I get myself, a Baneling nest here, because we do get free Banelings. And I think that's actually all we are going to get. I mean, I really don't need any more gas than this. So we'll pull the drones out of gas here very shortly, and we'll start making our Zerklings now as well. There we go. We'll send those straight across the map. Queen inject. Oh, there's something here. Very good. Going to be able to start up my Zerkling speed here. And actually, maybe I should consider getting the upgrade here as well for basically all of the units. Look at this, though. There's going to be a larva injector will pop off here very shortly. It's going to do a lot. It's going to do a lot. Zagara will be out here very soon as well. I'm trying to get another 100, I guess. Oh, God. He's got quite a lot of units here as well, though. Okay. Here we go, though. This is the production I was talking about. Look at that. So much stuff. Link speed will be done in just a little bit. I'm getting my Banes across the map now as well. Can he infest that? Oh, he can. That's what I was worried for. No, 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 no. Be careful, be careful, be careful. Oh! My god. I should not have allowed that SCV to stay alive. Look at the amount of damage here. Oh my god, it's the Apocalypse! I did not consider that. I did not consider that at all. No, Apocalypse, no! Well, there's no way I'm going to be able to kill that now, is there? Oh my god, I did not consider the Apocalypse. Alright, we got to go again, we got to go again. I got to make sure that I win with Zagara as well for the Swarm, right? We'll rush it out this time around, okay? No time to delay anything. We're not going to be focusing on macro here. Maybe I'll squeeze out some workers in just a little bit. But this is all going to be aggression. All going to be aggression. Now, we are going up against a Raynor right now. Raynor, of course, is working out a little bit differently in the sense that, you know what? I can make so much stuff here right from the get-go. I should probably just go ahead and do so. Anyway, regardless, I was going to say, he, of course, got the Banshees and whatnot available. He's got the Battlecruiser as well. He's got a lot of really powerful cooldowns. I'm not entirely sure if he can do anything here in the early game. But I'm going to be starting up my Zerklings right from the get-go. And we'll move. We'll move, Loco. No time to delay here. Apparently, I'm going to need an Overlord. And maybe I should start making some drones right now. Just because I don't think I'm going to be able to win with these Zerglings right here, right? I don't think actually continuing this will increase my chances of winning. So we'll grab ourselves a gas geyser here as well. We'll start creating a few workers. Is he already walled off? Oh, he's trying to at least. There's no way though. He's got... I got so many things here already, right? He's gonna try and go for the repair. I wonder. Maybe he can actually hold on to this. If I could try and kill the middle building, that would make it a lot easier. But now that it's finished up, he can also start repairing that one. He's gonna set up a bunker here as well. I think it's time for a massive baneling bust. Yeah, the first marine is now already out. Not quite what I had anticipated there. I was hoping I was gonna be able to get over there on the other end of the map before he could wall in like that. You know what? We'll set up a baneling nest here right from the get-go. And of course, we're only gonna need about 6 or so banes here to blow up this entire wall, so I don't think I'm gonna spend anything else here on getting any additional like upgrades here. We just need about 150 gas, and of course the first set of banelings will be free as well. I'm just a little bit worried though. Actually, they're only 14. They're only 14 gas each. I forgot about that. All right, we're gonna be able to bust this quite aggressively. I'll get a few additional ones just because we can. Zagara will be out shortly. I'll get up a spore crawler here as well for static defense, just when my opponent starts moving across. As soon as I can, I also want to make sure that I move across the map here with Zagara. Okay, here we go. Now, I have no time to scout here if there's any static defense or anything crazy up on this ramp. There we go. That should supply block him as well. Oh my god, the banshees are here. This is what I was worried for. No. Snap, he's actually getting himself an expansion out now as well. Not quite what I had anticipated. I guess the only way I can actually get the Tectonal to move is going to be with an Overseer. And in order to get that, I'm going to need a lair. Zagara will, of course, provide me all the static defense, or all of the anti-air rudder that I need here to defend against the banshees here, at least initially. But this is still not going to be that easy, though. I was secretly hoping that I was going to be capable of getting across the map. Now, luckily for me, Zagara should be available here very shortly. Oh, come on. Oh, no. He's just going to be able to kill the... Oh, my God. He just kills everything. Zagara! Help, please! Well, that's the last of my drones. That's the last of my drones. All right. Well, Zagara's out now. We're not giving up just yet. I'm producing drones once again. Oh, man. All right, I was hoping Zagara would be good, but Zagara is turning out to be a little bit unreliable. You know what? I'm gonna try and do that Stukov thing myself. I went for the Infest Structure cooldown, which should be very, very helpful, and then the Apocalypse cooldown as well. That seemed like a really fun strategy. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So Infest Structure will be available reasonably early on into the game, okay? I'm gonna try and put that right on top of my opponent's main base right from the beginning. Now, we're going up against a Kerrigan right now as well.
Main objective located. It must be destroyed.
I think I'm just gonna go ahead and set my Infested Structure just across the map here as well, just like he did in that game that we just played. I don't think I really need to get a whole lot other than just simply a barracks here, and I can start moving across the map quite easily. Of course, once I get my Apocalypse out, right, which is going to be really early on, I'm just not going to be able to die anymore. So really, like, surviving until that point is probably going to be our main objective. I'm trying to look here if I got any static defense on this commander. Actually, we do have the bunker, of course, which should be really helpful. We'll save up for that for just a little while. And this SCV will go in right around the time that the Infest Structure will be available as well. There we go. Barracks will soon be finishing up. We're just going to play the survival game, okay? We're just going to be safe. I'm trying to think here as well what Kerrigan could potentially be doing. But really, Kerrigan doesn't really have that many tricks up her sleeve. Other than maybe some early game Zerking aggression or whatever. But I think we can deal with that. There we go. The Apocalypse will just absolutely murder everything, right? I don't think I'm missing anything important in that sense, right? I mean, otherwise we still have the Alexander here ready to go as well. So, I mean, this bunker should be able to defend against all of the early game pressure. We got 45 seconds, so roughly around the 3-minute mark, I'm going to be able to put up the aggression on the other end of the map. We do need to finish this one up, though. Ooh, snap. Okay. Very good. Now we can go into the main of my opponent. Oh, you guys, no, I didn't mean that. Alright, infest is gonna be done very, very soon. Okay, there we go, got it. And it should line up brilliantly as well, because I think these things will still be available by the time I get across the map. I'll send out an SCV here as well, across, just in case. But I need to make sure that I still have detection by the time my Apocalypse is gonna be available in roughly 20 seconds from now. I don't know if it's gonna be that big of a deal. Kerrigan will be out here in just a bit too. I'll set up another bunker just in case. Yeah, I sadly don't have that much detection anymore here for the time being. It's okay. We actually don't really want to auto-cast that if we can at all. Can we turn that off? Oh, apparently you can't. Okay, Apocalypse is ready as well. Just gonna try and like launch it before I can die, I guess. But there we go. Get him! Get Kerrigan! This is so dirty. Alright. Alright, just kill the base then. Still gonna be able to get it, right? Yep. Look at that damage output, it's absolutely insane. And with that, my opponent says not bad. And we have obtained the victory. Alright, next up is Karax. I mean, power set 3 is probably going to be crucial, right? Initial and maximum Spear of Adun energy will just be so incredibly powerful, just because I can start raining damage to my opponent's mineral line right at the first second that the game begins. I think we're actually up against the same guy here. Yeah. I'll go ahead and send my probe across the map right away, but look at that, the Spear of Adun, I got Orbital Strike right from the get-go. I can always defend here with, you know, with my beams as well, I suppose. And on top of that, I can start cannon rushing like no tomorrow.
Main objective detected. Destroy at will.
I just gotta try and make sure that I don't lose the first probe, though. That would be bad. Anyway, of course, I can go ahead and put up instant cannons, right? But I'm gonna be able to get there right before my opponent can really achieve anything, right? Okay. What? No way! That's so not fair! I can almost kill his base. I can almost kill Kerrigan here. That was ridiculous. I could have actually killed his base. Maybe I still can. This is so not fair. You know it's bad when Loco starts cackling, like... I'm just waiting for energy here. No! Fuck, no! It's all good. That control was nothing to write home about, but it's all good. Here's the thing, though. He's gonna still be able to get quite aggressive here. So I think I am gonna need at least some early game defense here as well. Just because there's a chance my opponent will just simply try and murder me. We can, of course, get plus 2 ranged. Plus 2 range will allow me to hit that as, you know, his base as well. Alright. Yeah, sadly. Oh, I can build on creep! I forgot about that! This is, of course, co-op! You can build on your opponent's creep! Or your ally's creep, rather. That's ridiculous! I can just simply build it right in here! There's no way! I mean, he's still gonna try and bank on the fact that, you know, Kerrigan can potentially win this one right away. Can we kill the cocoon that she's spawning in? Apparently we cannot. Alright, you know what? We're gonna go home. Maybe I should actually just build up a few cannons. Right over here. I gotta go home though, because I need to make sure that I, you know, kill Kerrigan before she arrives and raffix my entire base, right? I need to make sure that that is gonna be the case. So we'll save up some energy here as well on the Spear of Adun so we can nuke her down right from the get-go, right as she makes her way across the map. Actually, I can just use it right when she's, you know, coming out as well. He just left. He wasn't feeling that. Alright, next up we're gonna give the commander a try that I think is probably going to be the weakest in this entire mutation. Regardless, I'm gonna go ahead and give it a try. We need to make sure that we wall off as soon as we possibly can though, because Swann is gonna have a tough time surviving. Alright, here goes nothing. So we'll have to try and be very safe here. Now we are going up against a Kerrigan. Once again, 3 in a row apparently. I don't know really exactly why Kerrigan would be so extremely powerful. Regardless, we'll try and build up an army consisting of Goliaths, I suppose. Goliaths are incredible.
Main objective detected. You may destroy it when ready.
Thank you. I'm gonna try my very best. But we'll have to be a little bit careful here. So I believe I don't really need any mineral. No, I don't really need any gas here initially. So I'll try and make sure that I wall off ASAP. It's gonna be really important because if my opponent rushes me with Zerklings or whatever, I'm just not gonna be able to do a whole lot. Okay, there we go. And we'll set up our wall just like that. I believe that in order to make this as well, we need the engineering bay. Yes, exactly. So, actually, no, we need the factory. Okay, so not only for the spinning dizzy is when we need the engineering bay. It's funny, because I play quite a lot of co-op. I've played a heck of a lot of Swann as well. But the thing is that you don't really build that much static defense when you're actually playing co-op and, you know, you're just simply building units. Generally speaking, that's not going to be your top priority. We'll build up some static defense here right at the front of my base. Kerrigan should be able to do quite a bit of damage to it, though, so I'm going to try and be reasonably safe. Oh no, I didn't mean to load up into that thing. That wasn't necessary. Okay. Of course, once my laser drill is done, which is going to be in just a bit, we're actually going to not be in that bad of a situation anymore. Okay. We'll set up a couple of these things. How much do you even cost? 150 minerals? You expensive! There we go. It's going to be all about playing defensive here, though. I'll send out one scouting SCV as well, just in case, because I don't want to be caught off guard with my opponent expending really early on. There's a chance that that is actually going to happen. And actually, this may be like your regular Terran versus Zerg, with less than regular units. I'm not going to assume here, though, that my opponent is playing a safe style here. I'm not going to assume that that is going to be the case. Anyway, I will be able to start up my Goliaths here very shortly. I actually can't produce a tech lab over here, which is a little unfortunate. That's okay. Let's see what he's up to. He already got his spawning pool done. He's researching something in the Evo chamber. So I think I should just simply go ahead and make sure that I get more static defense here ready to go. Okay. Let's try and see if I can produce another Goliath here as well. He's probably going to go for a lot of Zerklings. So maybe a second one of those, like, flaming Bettys is not that bad of an idea. We'll get another one right up there. And with my Dragon Laser Drill almost done here already, I actually feel pretty safe. I mean, I'm not entirely sure how strong Kerrigan is going to be, though. I do have also my Ares bolts, of course, ready to go. Which I could use to actually clean up his base, but we'll use it defensively here, okay? We're trying to simply get a really large army out. Gigawatts. Whew! So sick. Alright, let's go ahead and get myself another depot out. Luckily, we can power build him. I can also build myself an armory, and there my opponent is located. Look at that! We're actually murdering him. We're actually dealing so much damage here. Do I drop my Ares bots? Alright, I think we have to. Okay. Very good. I'm gonna need all of the upgrades here that I can get as well, by the way. And I think I may very well even want to try and get myself an expansion out. I'm going to be in some trouble, though, very soon. Just because I won't have all too much stuff. You know what? I'm actually not going to get an expansion or anything out just yet. My opponent is actually expended, though. Okay, we can actually kill her. That's huge. That means that we can also kill the base now. As long as we have vision, we're going to be able to kill this just fine. Try and nuke it down. Nuke it down, boys! Good. That's actually a big deal. That's actually a really big deal. Okay, I got it. Very nice. And very shortly, I'm going to be able to get my Ares class targeting system. Increase the Goliath's anti-air attack range and its ground weapon range as well. And then we can also go ahead and use the multi... No. Yeah, no. We do get those upgrades. They're actually really powerful just because they make the Goliath so much stronger. I can also try and get out a starport here. Which should allow me to start producing the science vessels. Just in case my opponent decides to get cheeky. And we can also, of course, use that to heal up my Goliath's. So all things considered, this is probably as good as it could have been. Not sure if I can even produce this many at once, though. I'm trying to produce as much as I can here, but... this is going to be rather pricey. Now, of course, Kerrigan does take a while to respawn, right? So we have a bit of time here to build up once again as well. I don't really need any additional gas income here. So there she is, once again. I'm a little worried that I don't have enough. Oh no. Oh no. It looked so brilliant for a second. Look at the amount of healing that she gets back though.
Okay, try and heal him up.
Oh!
And I think that's gonna be the last of the workers that I have.
Snap! This was such a good early game!
No, I'm not gonna be able to do a whole lot anymore, because now the Zerkins have arrived and they can jump up on walls. And sadly, we're gonna end up falling.
You know what? I don't have Raynor at the max level myself just yet, but let's go ahead and give it a try anyway.
Okay, so we're up against the Vorazun here. Vorazun, of course, has got the Dark Templar. We basically just need to make sure we kill him before that happens. I'm believing here, I'm pretty sure at the very least, that I'm going to be capable of dropping Marines through the Vorg of War, right? So I'll just go ahead and simply build up a barracks just like that. And I think we'll rally it straight over there.
Detected. You may destroy it when ready.
I think this should work, right? I'm not entirely sure. We're not going to get any additional workers. I think my only defense against the Vorazun DTs here is to make sure that we can actually... kill them before they arrive. I can load up into my command center as well, I guess. Or can I even do that? Yeah, no, we can. But anyway, I'm gonna set my rally points just across the map, and I'm pretty sure they will arrive here, right? I'm pretty sure the drop pod should arrive right here. There it is. Oh no. I'm gonna have to try and do damage. I'm on a DT timer. Quick! No, why did you get supply book, Loco, you idiot? Alright. He doesn't understand my DT timer reference. Mister, you're level 90. You're level 90 mastery. You should be alright at knowing this, right? This is the ultimate. The ultimate rush here, though, with Marines. Look at this. This is ridiculous. We need to try and kill that thing, though. With that, we're going to be capable of just simply destroying everything else. This is cheese heaven, though. If you are someone that enjoys cheese, and I don't mean like, you know, the kind of cheese you put on bread. I'm still worried, though, because I don't even know what the requirement is for Forazun's stuff. You know what? I can always lift up. I can always lift up. I could have always lifted up, right? If my opponent would just simply sit back and tried to, you know, get his Dark Templar out, I could have always just lifted up with my command center and still survive for a little while longer. And for the last one for today, let's give Nova a try as well. I think she should be pretty good as well. If we can get some units out with the defense drone and whatnot and the Griffin Airstrike, would be absolutely incredible. For that very reason, I got the Griffin Airstrike cost reduction, Nova attack speed increase, as well as the unit life regeneration, just to hopefully get a bit of a balanced composition. Ah, snap, I'm actually up against the guy that I faced in the previous match, and now he is playing Raynor. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do a whole lot here. I'm actually not gonna create anything. I just need to make sure that I get myself the barracks out ASAP, because I'm gonna need to get like 600 minerals, right, in order to create my first set of Marines. I think that's what I'm gonna need here. Once Nova's out, we're gonna be alright. But I need to make sure that I get my defensive Marines out ASAP. So we'll just save up, I guess. We won't make anything but just the first set of Marines, because he's gonna probably do the strategy that I just executed against him, where he's just gonna simply send Marines across the map. At the very least, I'm pretty sure it's the same guy. Regardless, as long as we finish up this barracks, as long as we can get our defensive drones out, I think we're gonna be reasonably safe. I don't know yet if he's actually gonna be doing this strategy, though, so we'll see. I will either way make sure that I get myself a bunch of Marines out, of course. We need to make sure that we get some other units out very shortly as well. With Nova, we may be able to counter the Banshees, although I'm not convinced we can.
Not enough minerals.
Okay, here we go. And now I guess I can start moving out as well. I mean, maybe I should have actually just moved them across the map right away. This actually is a little silly by me. I don't know really exactly why I pushed them right there in my main base. That was a little bit dumb. A little bit dumb. Anyway, we'll start building up some more income here as well. And actually, I can go for a Griffin airstrike really early on too. Maybe we can use that against the Banshees once they come in. Alright. I really have no time building SUVs here. I don't even know if I could have actually dropped these things in the fog of war. Look at this though. Alright. Here we go. Gonna be able to deal with those just fine. Look at those Marines, though. They're stupid powerful. There's just a handful of them as well. We can always go ahead and drop ourselves the, you know, the defensive drone as well if we absolutely need to. I guess I can just put up one of them. But there we go. Nova will be out here very shortly too. And my opponent just simply GG's. That was dirty. That was really dirty. Alright, this is gonna be the actual final match, alright? I'm gonna try my very best here to Griffin Airstrike my opponent. I just really badly want to give it a try, see if I can make it work. We do need to send out an SCV a little bit earlier. We are going up against the Vorazun now, which is sort of like the perfect timing, I guess, for me. Let's give him the GLHF, because I think he's gonna need it. Actually, I can't build any SCVs. I cannot afford any SCVs here. So we'll send this SCV here across the map as well. And I'll try and see if I can potentially... I wanna like blow up a mineral line using the Griffin Airstrike. I think it would be really strong. It's just that I'm already giving up a lot of economy here. And of course, I'm on a bit of a timer here now as well because I am going up against Vorazun. Alright. Barracks almost done. We could even drop on our SCV, I guess, but... Get in there. We do need vision, right? We do need vision. We're gonna have about 30 seconds remaining here. Of course, those are Blizzard seconds. Not to be confused with actual seconds. but we can also follow this up, I guess, with some Elite Marines. This is actually, like, supply-wise and income-wise, this is actually lining up surprisingly well. 5 seconds remaining. I'm gonna need 760 minerals. All right, here we go. That was way too good. All right. Nice. Now we just need to try and not die in the process to a bunch of Dark Templar. Nothing happened. Don't even ask about it. I think that the Marines would have probably been better, but my opponent left the game. Nice. Man, I'm not gonna lie, these are awesome mutation missions. I would love to see something like this a little bit more regularly. Of course it's not balanced, right? Of course some of the commanders are gonna be weaker than the others, but this was really, really, really cool. I hope you enjoy watching this video as well. The mutation mission is only available today, so if you are watching this on April 1st, make sure to give it a try, because it's awesome. Other than that, though, I want to thank you for watching. Have an amazing day. Do not forget to smile, alright? And I will see you in the next one.